to death.
Welcome to the Game Awards 2022. Now, here's your host, the creator of the Game Awards, Jeff Keighley.
Oh, hey, Alana and
hello, everybody, and welcome Raul to the Game Awards. It feels so amazing to be back in person with the fans and to have the entire industry with us here tonight. I love it. Such great energy. Want to say hello to all the nominees.
Really wasn't expecting
Mr. Miyazaki,
for them
great to have you here, nominated for Game of the Year tonight.
Raul and Alana to show up.
Kratos himself, Christopher Judge, is in the house. Man Engage, incredible in Immortality. Welcome to the Game Awards. And of course, we have Phil Spencer from Xbox with us. Welcome, Phil. Doug Bowser from Nintendo. You saw him accepting an award already in the opening act.
And Joseph Ferris.
Lots more awards to come. And of course, last year's Game of the Year winner, Joseph Ferris, is back. Good to see you, Joe. Everyone's here. Look, even Animal is here, guys.
Love him.
Can't take him anywhere. I should have booked Kermit. All right, well, welcome to all the nominees and to all of you watching live around the world. Thank you for being a part of this community. Tonight, we are going to honor the best games of the year and show you what's next with an absolutely incredible world premiere lineup, including the first ever look at the gameplay of Star Wars Jedi Survivor from Respawn.
Nice.
An update on Final Fantasy 16. The first ever clip from the Super Mario Brothers movie.
First ever?
And
what do you mean?
Many, many new game announcements and surprises. Trust me, we've got a lot of things, no leaks. We're very excited about what we're about to share with you guys. Now, though, it's time for our first award. To present it, I am so honored to welcome one of the great actors of our generation or any other. He's a two-time Tony winner, a two-time Emmy winner, and an Academy Award winner. Please join me in welcoming to the Game Awards, Al Pacino.
Why? Why? Why is Al Pacino here?
So cool. Thank you. Hello, everyone. It's really good to see you here. This is an experience for me. what I didn't expect, but here I am, as usual, doing my surprising thing to myself. But anyway, I may come as it may come as a shock to you, but I'm it's hard for me to see the teleprompter. But anyway, in truth, I don't play a whole lot of video games.
That's fine.
But I do have, however, spent a lot of time watching my kids play them.
Sure.
Yeah. And I've continued to be thoroughly impressed and entertained by the unique and immersive ways video games tell their stories.
Sure.
And especially naturally, by the performers who help tell these stories. Because as an actor, I've learned
that
whether you're on a stage or in front of a camera or inside an audio booth. Always, fundamentally, always, we're the same. We are all trying to tell a story.
Sure.
In our way, with our kind of truth. And I am honored to be here tonight.
Come on.
To celebrate the achievements of these incredibly talented actors who, by breathing life into these stories,
so sad,
have helped elevate the medium of video games to a new height.
Okay. Does he not wear glasses?
And now,
can't you make the text bigger?
For the best performance of the year. Oh.
Best performance.
I have to find a way to fix it all. And the answer is somewhere out in the Forbidden West. Everything was so nice and quiet. Go to hell!
And still I follow.
Death can have me. Do what is necessary.
I don't find boys have much to say for themselves. You don't scare me.
I can't talk about it. But you don't believe in any of it. Who's keeping you safe?
Best performance. I'm working out now. This is heavy.
It's written there,
finally,
dude.
Finally, I didn't work out today, so I'm doing... You don't mind, do you, if I do a little each? The best performance winner, Christopher Judge for God of War Ragnarok.
Ragnarok. Man, getting an award from Al Pacino, man.
Shit.
Yeah.
Now I see why I couldn't get more than a plus one. Thank you to the Game Awards. First of all, I have to thank my mama. Whose belief that I would amount to something good would never waver. Even though it looked like I'd never amount to anything good. My brother, who's my hero, at 40, changed his life, went to medical school, and is now Dr. Judge. My children. Who I am forever proud of, forever thankful of, and still the best role I've ever had is being your dad.
Yeah. This is really significant, man.
Sony Santa Monica. Miss Yumi Yang. It is an honor and a pleasure to work for you and with you. You are a unicorn because you actually proved that for the first time ever, the trickle-down theory actually worked. Corey Barlog, thank you, brother. Thank you for believing in me, and thank you for having me read for the role. I was the last actor in California to read for it. And Corey said to me he didn't think I would do it. And if I had known it was a video game back then, I might not have. Boy, how things have changed. Matt, Rich, Dory, Bruno, Erica, Bees, all, everyone who made that volume so special and so sacred, everyone at every level, be it designer, be it whatever it was, who worked under extraordinary conditions to get this game out. Mr. Eric Williams.
Man, this is a long speech.
I think it's kind of common knowledge that we were honored to go to Tribeca after 2018. And when Corey took me outside and said he wouldn't be directing the next one, I literally did quit. I quit. And he said, nah, I vouch for Eric. And I said, Eric Williams better be a beast. Eric Williams is a motherfucking beast.
Nice.
I relate to Corey on kind of a artistic level, a level of that side of me. Eric Williams and I are from such the same place, two different parts of the country, two different upbringings, but two from a very similar emotional place. And I'll never forget, I guess I can't say what it was, but it was something that moved me so deeply. And there's a time frame that cinematics have to fit into. Hopefully not speeches. And I couldn't reel it in. And Eric came over to me. And he just hugged me and just held me as I was sobbing. And then he said words I will never forget. Okay, big guy, now give us one we can use. To
end there.
This amazing, wonderful group of actors. Who brought as much or more than I did every single day. I mean, we were in there, and the bravery of this group of actors to share their heartache, their loves, their lost loves, their loneliness. I am so grateful and thankful that I got to spend
all
those days
off
in that volume with you. This is for all of us. Sonny. I wasn't lying, I voted for you. Your work was astounding.
Yeah, you gotta wrap it up.
The future of this. Just never forget the two things I hopefully gave you. Hire me. Don't be a douchebag.
Yeah. That's it. You gotta leave.
To every single person in this room, no matter what game it was you touched, you are heroes because you got so many people in the world through a very difficult, dark time that's still not over. Games and the gaming community means so much to this world, so much in the course of dreams and
you made it more epic.
And just being better. Thank you. Thank you to the wrestling nominees. Have a great night. And I met Al Pacino.
Man, Jeff is stressed.
Great moment, Chris Judge. I think he was trying to give away a few extra Steam Decks as well. All right, it's time to get the announcements rolling here at the Game Awards. Tonight, many of the world's top studios are here at the Game Awards to give you a glimpse at the exciting future of video games in 2023 and beyond. Our first world premiere comes from a small but highly acclaimed studio that needs no introduction at this point and whose last game earned multiple awards here at TGA. I'm very excited to share the global announcement of their next project. Here we go.
What is this? Multiple awards? Ooh. Oh. What? Is this Hades related? The music is very, very, very reminiscent. Nice. Yeah. She also has laurels. What's going on here? And the animation is so good.
Good.
Is it Hades too?
We can but learn. And the greatest teacher is out there. Now go. Death to Kronos.
Death to Kronos.
It is Hades.
This is an opportunity for you.
Holy shit. For
the least I can do is light your way down.
Not ready to give in?
No. I was born for this.
Holy shit.
Joyful with powers far beyond your comprehension, witch.
Okay, if I call you witch like that.
Is it Hades 2? What are you going to call it?
He is no mere titan. He is time itself. And time cannot be stopped.
Wait for me, Father. I'll be this.
Jesus! Awesome.
And trust me, we are just getting started. Hades 2 is the next game and first ever sequel now in development at Supergiant Games, like the original, which was revealed here at TGA in 2018. Hades 2 is going to be developed in Early Access, so your feedback can help shape the game, and news on Early Access is coming in 2023.
Awesome.
Next, I'm so excited about this one. We're taking a journey to an exciting new world with a world premiere from a studio led by someone with a legacy of building incredible narrative-driven games and creating genre-defining experiences.
Okay.
It's moments like this
that
get
Kojima?
Me excited about the future of our medium.
Is it Kojima because you're creaming your pants? I don't know what this is. Oh, Ken Levine?
Is dying. And my only way out of here is with one of them.
This looks so good.
Johnny Fever, as the moon flower
Man, if 2K won't do Bioshock, just do Bioshock by yourself.
People say I have this coming. And you know what? They're right.
Awesome. Awesome. Ken Levine.
Few surprises tonight. That was a first look at Judas coming from Ghost Story Games, led by Ken Levine, who has created immersive gaming worlds like Rapture and Columbia. A few months ago, I visited the studio in Boston and played multiple hours of this game, and let me tell you, everything you saw there is in-engine. Ghost Story Games is also exploring different approaches to narrative that you will learn about in the future. Let me just say, I can't wait for them to tell you more. Didn't that look fantastic? Exciting stuff.
It did look fantastic.
All right, well, let's go to another brand new game announcement for the fans here at the Game Awards.
How's there a Bayonetta announcement? Sorry, it was an announcement, right? Is it DLC? Are you going back to the first Bayonetta? Is it a prequel?
I can't turn back now.
Cereza, you must never enter that forest.
Okay.
You would soon become a snack for one of the fairies who live there.
How could a Dankong forest be that scary a place anyway? Oh! Must have been a rabbit or something. Right, Chishi? Did I manage to summon a demon that has now possessed Chishi?
Pretty cool. It's a way to explore story.
My dearest Cereza.
Mummy? Don't worry, I'll send you home.
Go to Avalon Forest. The white wolf will guide you.
I am going to be a witch. I need to be strong.
I will give you the power to save your mother.
Nice.
Cereza and the Lost Demon.
Cool. What? Nice.
Eat up! Oh.
That's right, following on the heels of Bayonetta 3, it won't be long until you get to play this brand new action-adventure game in the Bayonetta series on March the 17th. All right, there are lots more new game announcements and awards to come, but tonight you also have a shot at some cool free stuff just for watching the Game Awards. On Steam, Valve is giving away a Steam Deck every minute to a viewer of the show. So I was going to start talking slowly, but I probably should start talking a little quicker after Chris's speech, but I'm so glad that he won that award. But seriously, Steam Deck is incredible, and you can watch on Steam.tv. We also have Twitch viewer rewards. Watch 60 minutes of the show tonight on our Twitch channel, and you'll get the limited edition Jeff Keighley Among Us mask. Yes, it's back. An awesome Kate Diaz from Gears of War costume in Fall Guys, and a full free game, Rogue Legacy, on the Epic Games Store, and more.
Nice.
We'll be right back with a spectacular performance from Hozier and the Game Awards Orchestra, more awards announcements, and yes, Animal from the Muppets will be back.
people in the server are my family. I remember being at my lowest point. The members of this server were here for me.
Seeing everyone in the Discord, this world of passion and grief, but in a positive light.
I have been through so much with these people.
This really made me believe that video games can help people heal.
Mm-hmm. Cool.
We love how you have fun. From serving up sports at home to competing and cooperating in fresh ways, catching new adventures in vast worlds. So, what's next? More fun. From adorable adventures to blasts from the past. And much, much more.
Okay. What is this? Oh, Nintendo? Is it a Nintendo thing? Cool. I hope Nintendo shows something. And they have
to,
right?
To having fun, the sky's the limit. See where the fun takes you in 2023.
Sure.
Rated M for mature. There's no hope. But I've got to escape. Every sound, every movement.
And they couldn't actually animate the logo. It had to be motion graphics.
This dead moon. It's not done with me yet. Just one thing to do. Survive.
San Francisco. The city by the bay is under siege by forces not of this world. We need new heroes. Fearless recruits. With the guts to look evil in the eye. Who are we gonna call? You.
Oh, cool.
We go, PKE meters out.
I got a few hits. Hold on me.
Blast it! I'm covered in mini puffs.
Behind you.
I love the mini puffs.
Tap out.
I'm being very ironic. I just deeply dislike close. Them.
Holy. We're gonna need a bigger trap.
Ghostbusters, Rise of the Ghost Lord, coming in 2023.
Sure.
One of my favorite parts of this show is bringing video game music to life on stage. Now to perform Blood Upon the Snow from tonight's most nominated game, God of War Ragnarok. Please welcome multiple platinum Grammy-nominated Hozier featuring Bear McCreary and the Game Awards Orchestra conducted by Lauren Balfe.
Nice. Is that a hurdy-gurdy? Is that a fucking hurdy-gurdy? It is a fucking hurdy-gurdy. That's actually Bear McCreary, yeah. Is he even mic'd up?
The ground warped here is a wonder.
it ceases never to hunger. All things nature's given, she takes all.
What an amazing instrument, really. This choir. Just how cold the wind. It's because you're Irish.
I've no more hunger now to see where the road will go. I've no more kept my warmth than blood upon the snow.
He sounds Irish. He is Irish. And the guy's playing a medieval instrument like it's a fucking electric guitar. And the music is very, very Irish sounding. And Hozier is huge, and Bear apparently is tiny.
Wow, what an incredible performance. The Game Awards Orchestra, I'm grateful to have them back again, and it's sincerely a joy to hear the music from games we love come to life on this stage. It's amazing what that orchestra puts together in just a few weeks of rehearsal. They'll be back later in the show to pay tribute to our Game of the Year nominees. This year, a record-setting number of you voted, 55 million for the Game Awards on our website, on Bilibili in China, and on our Discord server. You can head over to discord.gg/thegameawards tonight to join in the discussion about the show. Right now, to present our next award from the new film Glass Onion, A Knives Out Mystery, premiering December 23rd on Netflix, please welcome Jessica Hennick.
I don't want to alarm anyone.
Oh, I love this actress.
But someone in this room is a murderer.
It had to be Bossman.
Just kidding, we're just joking around. But also, statistically speaking, someone in this theater probably is a murderer. I'm sorry. Let's not think about that. Anyway, I don't want to spoil our film, but I can tell you that there is a very popular video game featured in it. And now, to give you some more clues, please welcome writer-director Rian Johnson and the star of Glass Onion, Daniel Craig.
Thank you, Jessica Hedgewick. And hello, Game Awards.
We are so excited for you to see our new film. We have a special scene in
it. Is Daniel Craig Irish?
So we wanted to bring a little something to that game. That's you. That's Ben Wobblock. Look at him. This is adorable.
I mean, it's a nice scarf.
I like the cravat. It's very, very nice. Yeah.
And now, here are the nominees.
He's English.
Best debut indie.
We're sinners plucked from hell to do God's dirty work. And I'm finding it hard to believe we're in heaven.
Is that Chris Sabat? Man. I don't know, but I think Vampire Survivors should probably win.
And the Game Award for Best Debut Indie goes to Stray.
Oh, nice. This is a lot of pressure.
Yeah.
able to actually. Thank you. Thank you so much. It's an incredible honor. On behalf of the whole team in Montpellier that is probably watching right now, hi guys. I want to thank everyone that was involved in making this this game. It's really a work of love and passion, and all the talented members of our team put everything they have to make this game real. Thanks to everyone who has helped us along the way, our friends, families, partners, companions, dogs, cats, obviously, pretty important. Annapurna Interactive, you guys are amazing. You make dreams happen.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. You've been with us the whole way through.
The good publishers make the difference.
And yeah, thank you to the players. We put such a big part of our lives making this game, so seeing people enjoy it and react to it is the best feeling in the world. So thank you. Merci. Merci beaucoup.
Congratulations, Stray, and now an exclusive first look at the gameplay from Lightfall, Destiny 2's next chapter, launching in February. Join your fellow Guardians to master the cosmic powers of the universe and cancel
the
apocalypse.
Shut up.
When we think about controlling something powerful, it's easy to assume it takes strength. But what I've learned through loss, we can overcome the impossible. I'm used to the darkness.
Hey! Okay. Nice effect there, the camera. Very pretty, but it's not what the players are going to see. That looks significantly different. How is this the same game as Destiny? The original. Cool. Oh, finally.
We gotta keep looking. There.
Don't use the Arkham music.
All right, flash is clear. Keep your eyes on him, people. Somebody find the back entrance.
Best dirty movie I ever saw. Oh, crap!
This door will not hold. We must barricade it.
You stay here, pal.
See this? I spent a lot of time dreaming up how I was gonna kill you with it. You're mine now, and you're in for a world of...
Oh no.
Oh, shit! You hear that?
It's too quiet.
Please help me!
Hey, Bruce! Still using shadows to scare the crap out of us criminals, huh?
Oh no, that's bad.
Don't sweat it. Batman doesn't kill people. Are you okay?
am vengeance.
Jesus, Kevin Conroy.
I am Batman.
Yeah. Yeah.
After 30 years as the iconic voice of Batman in the Arkham video games, Batman the Animated Series, and countless other DC projects, actor Kevin Conroy sadly passed away last month at the age of 66. He was such an iconic voice. He was so amazing in the Arkham games, and I know we're all going to miss him dearly. Well, tonight, we can share that he will return to Rocksteady's Arkhamverse one final time to play Batman in Suicide Squad, Kill the Justice League, when the game releases on May 26th of next year.
That's pretty cool. That's good to know.
We're going to miss you, Kevin. Now, as we think about the next phase of our industry, it's important to recognize those who represent the bright, bold, and inclusive future of gaming. That's why we have our Game Awards Future Class presented by Old Spice. And tonight, over 75 members of the class from the past 2 years are here in the audience. Hello, guys. And this week, we inducted the 2022 class of 50 new members. You can read about them at tgafutureclass.com. And right now, meet one of this year's new members, a chemist turned game dev at Innersloth, who also happens to be a street dancer.
Sure.
I'm Mick Minier. I'm the lead back-end programmer on Among Us, and I'm a street dancer named Dr. Robotnik. I was looking at the movement of NPCs in video games.
Get in line.
And realize that we as animation dancers have the unique ability to show the body control, the robotics. We have the ability to bend time and reality. It's really exciting. I think there's a lot of potential to bridge these two different art forms.